The YouTuber Blaire White had just surpassed 1 million subscribers. Then she uploaded a video where she got one thing wrong, but that one thing revealed a pattern of behavior that wound up causing a domino effect that sent her crashing under 1 million subscribers and hiding from the internet entirely. Hiding, that is, until she tried to come back last week.
But what I won't apologize for is what people have made up in their minds that I have done. One thing about it is I am not cancelable. I will not be run off social media by a bunch of 16-year-olds who 10 years ago would have been the emo kids, but now want to be the trans kids. Okay?
Hi, and welcome back to me talking about whatever I want. Today, I want to talk about Blaire White, but first, I want to talk about the elephant in the room. This is a surprise video. I mean, you may have noticed that I chose a spooky background and I'm dressed like an extra from a Netflix original. That's because this is my time to shine. This whole video is Halloween themed. I created it right before October 31st and actually planned on uploading it as like a surprise Halloween present, but Blaire White made a surprise appearance just a few days ago, so I had to add some things and correct some things. But basically, it's all still pretty bad. I mean, this video isn't really about Halloween, I'm just very much in that mood. You should have seen my costume this year, it was iconic. The real theme of this video is in three parts. In part one, we're going to look at who Blaire White is, what she did, and why she decided to run off right after doing it. In part two, I want to look at Blaire White's track record of mistakes and what they say about the kind of person that she is on YouTube. And I want to do this from the perspective of a former fan. And then in part three, I will react to Blaire's surprise apology return video, which, not a surprise, it wasn't very good. But before we get into all of that, I want to get into today's sponsor. And I must say, if you were like sad that I didn't wear my Halloween costume for this video, then this one's for you.
Today's video is brought to you by Vessi.
That's right, they came back after my last sponsorship where I poured water on their sneaker. They just can't stay away from me. And I just can't stay away from their lightweight knit shoes. So I'm gonna pour water on another one because they're actually waterproof. Look at that. The shoe still looks fashionable on the outside and it's completely dry on the inside. And therefore, it matches my personality to a T. Now, I own kind of a lot of pairs of shoes because I have a problem deep down. But instead of addressing all that, I just want to say that my Vessis are easily the lightest and most flexible pair of shoes that I own. Because the knit material is so breathable, heat and sweat escape super easily, so I can feel good and look good. Not like I need anybody's help to look good, but it's just like an added bonus. I like to go outside when it rains and take pictures like these, and now with these shoes, the rain literally bounces off of them. It's actually comical how little the rain affects me now. What I'm trying to say here is that with Vessis, I am more powerful than the weather. Anyway, click the link in my description to get $25 off your pair of Vessis today. That's vessifootwear.com/D'Angelo. Now let's get back to the video. So who is Blaire White and how did we get here? Blaire White is one of the most popular transgender YouTubers. She's an American YouTuber with nearly 1 million subscribers. She started around 2016 and she's just gotten more and more popular since then. She runs two channels on YouTube, Blaire Black, where she talks about her own personal experience with being transgender, along with a few reaction videos and other various content, and Blaire White, her self-titled main channel, where she talks about other people and their relation to the trans community. She has videos like I read J.K. Rowling's transphobic book, so you don't have to, the truth about Trump and the transgender community. Whenever this topic winds up getting mainstream press coverage, you can expect Blaire to put out a video and get a lot of views because people value her opinion. Now, while she does have a large LGBT following, it's worth noting that, from what I gather, the majority of Blaire's audience is actually not transgender. They're just cisgender people like me. So Blaire prides herself on being a sort of liaison between the transgender community and the rest of the general public.
Maybe provide some healing for the trans community and bridge a divide. I do feel like that's my purpose in general with everything that I do, so maybe that'll happen.
As far as liaisons go, she seems like the perfect candidate. She's rational, she's known for using fact-based evidence to clear up misconceptions about the trans community, and she's not afraid to cover the controversial topics. My understanding was that she does her best to paint a more positive picture of the trans community on the internet, since, let's be honest, they tend to get a bad rap because the loudest examples are always the strangest. I apologize now. Now, there are a lot of YouTubers like that, but it's worth noting that Blaire White is actually popular outside of YouTube for her unique political views. Blaire White is a conservative, which is a political party that many people don't typically associate with being transgender. She used to get a lot of press coverage for being the outspoken transgender Trump supporter. To be clear, she's not the only person with these beliefs, but she was easily the most prominent. I'm not sure whether she's still a Trump supporter or not, but she still very much leans into that conservative persona. Like, When I say that, I don't mean she's a normal conservative. She acts like a stereotype of the conservatives. Black Lives Matter is bad.
I did make videos about Black Lives Matter. I made one entitled, you know, straight to the point. I entitled it, Black Lives Matter is Trash.
Guns are good. People attacked me for wearing a MAGA hat in public. It's like, okay, we get it. Though I will say, the concept of a pink rifle is not lost on me. I've watched enough anime to appreciate that incongruency. Now, after uploading for years, Blaire kind of broke out on YouTube with her Exposing Trans Predators series. This expanded her channel into the mainstream. See, if you sort her videos by most popular, the two most popular ones are about Jessica Yaniv, who does happen to be transgender and is a confirmed predator. She got 2.3 million views on a saved live stream, which is extremely high. As you can see, her channel growth exploded, correlating with the time when this went live, and she gained over 100,000 subscribers in that month alone. So it's safe to say a sizable chunk of her audience is there for that reason. And one of those people in that audience was me. I used to be a huge Blaire White fan. I personally disagreed with her conservative opinions, but that was never what she really centered her content around when it comes to YouTube anyway. I mean, she is a writer for this conservative publication called The Postmillennial, but as far as her videos go, she mostly just provides a perspective on things that happen that's alternative to the ones people typically run with, and I found that fascinating. I was already aware that trans people get a disproportionately bad rap in the media, so I was all too willing to follow somebody like Blaire, who seemed rational, honest, and very eloquent, to say the least. And in retrospect, boy was I dumb. So between her unique stances, rising popularity, and her interesting position in the world of YouTube, Blaire White was pretty much set up for quick success from the start. But at the same time, I also believe that that's what set her up to fail. I think the craziest part is that at first, this just seemed like a completely normal video for Blaire White. She posted one called Trans Athlete, I Belong in Women's Sports, in which we see a quote attributed to this person in the thumbnail. In this video, Blaire criticizes trans athletes for, in her opinion, exploiting biological advantages over cis athletes. It started off like all her other videos as a basic premise. Blaire thinks it's unfair for trans women to compete with cis women in sporting events. She focused on three people as examples, powerlifter Janae Marie Kroc.
The idea, the concept of Janae competing against biological women is ludicrous. It's almost intentionally ignorant. And anyone who thinks that that is some sort of level playing field is a liar.
Runner Jude Eastwood.
Madison and her teammate Mary Marshall believe losing to Eastwood was unfair since Eastwood was born a male.
And boxer Patricio Manuel.
I would hope that no rational person thinks that this guy should compete on the women's team simply because he was born biologically female.
All three of whom, Blaire explained, were trans athletes competing against cisgender people. Next, Blaire provides a reasoning for her premise using the examples. She states that she wouldn't find it unfair for transgender men to compete against cis men because there's no biological advantage.
I think he's clearly more fitted to compete on a men's team so long as he meets the standards to be on that team.
Lastly, Blaire suggests alternatives and solutions for her perceived problem. In this case, her idea is that maybe there could be separate categories.
And here's another thing no one ever talks about. Is there any real argument why there shouldn't be trans leagues?
That is the basic structure of all Blaire White videos. Introduce, opinionate, illustrate, and solve. She basically does all of the work for her audience. And I think typically that's a pretty rational way of approaching things. That's why Blaire is so effective at garnering such a large audience. Turns out there was just one tiny problem with this particular video. The information that Blaire presented about Janae was just completely incorrect. Janae Marie Kroc does not participate against cis women in bodybuilding and powerlifting events. How do we know that? Because Janae was actually already famous too. She's a very prominent figure in the powerlifting world. So much so that there's a whole exercise named after her called Kroc Rose. Her entire story is public information. In fact, it was all shown in a documentary called Transformer. In this documentary, we see that Janae never at any point enters a women's competition. In fact, the only event she goes to is specifically one for transgender people, and she doesn't even participate in that one. Now, the reason why this was blatant misinformation was because Blaire didn't just say it would be unfair for Janae to compete against biological women. Blaire said that she did compete against biological women, flipping back and forth between categories.
But Janae actually went back post-transition and competed against men just because, I guess. Like, it was kind of like, she's gone back and forth.
Even though this never happened, Blaire holds this against her for the entire video.
I mean, that's just a dick move. No pun intended.
Janae is also the thumbnail image for this video, as well as the opening clip Blaire includes. So this whole video framed Janae for something she didn't do. On her Instagram, Janae mentions that the back and forth Blaire is talking about wasn't between men and women's categories, but just whether or not she wanted to compete in the men's at all. So Janae tried to speak up. Janae left a comment on Blaire's video. She said that she was respectful of Blaire's opinions, but that she had spread a lot of misinformation. Blaire didn't respond. Janae posted on her Instagram that Blaire's video was incorrect and it was causing her to get hate. She restated in her Instagram post that she's only ever broken records in the men's division and has no plans of ever competing against other women. And Blaire didn't respond. Janae asked for legal advice on what she could do about this misinformation being spread against her, and unfortunately, she wasn't given any good answers. So far, this has all been pretty standard stuff. An influencer makes a mistake, desperately tries to ignore it in the hopes that it goes away, and then it doesn't. But this is where it gets really weird. Blaire White didn't just ignore the criticism on her video. She actually disappeared from the internet. Blaire just stops posting on all social media platforms as the criticism against her continues to mount. Meanwhile, this video was still up and continuing to get views. People had started to catch on to her spread of misinformation in a pretty big way. The YouTuber Sam Collins called her out and got pretty much the same amount of views as Blaire's video did, and that's actually where I found out about the situation. Then the criticism started to spill over onto other platforms. And that's how you know things are getting bad.
So, you're gonna open up about the fact that you blatantly lied about Janae Kroc or not? When are you gonna apologize to Janae Kroc for lying about her? 1 week later and you have been radio silent.
Blaire's subscribers had caught on, and her subscriber count was starting to get lower and lower. She was starting to drop below 1 million fairly quickly. Blaire's entire comment section on that video was just full of people pointing out that she was spreading misinformation. And somehow, Blaire still didn't take it down. Then, the Blaire White commentary video storm started. Because that always starts when these things happen. Blaire's response of not responding was so weird that people outside of this started making videos about it.
Blaire White lies about transgender athlete Janae Kroc. Blaire White actually crosses a line here. Blaire White can't stop lying.
See, in making these responses, people found other things that Blaire had done. She had spread misinformation before. She seemingly lied about things that could be easily proven before. Heck, she even had her own blackface controversy. Why is there literally always a blackface controversy? Like, why is that a theme with these videos? Basically, it turns out that Blaire White was kind of just awful in general. The theme of the commentary videos very quickly turned from Blaire White is running away from this one mistake that she made, which was true, to Blaire White has a track record of fairly recent yet questionable behavior that she refuses to change or even acknowledge. And that's true too. And do you know what Blaire said during all of this? Nothing. So at this point, people just wanted to know where was she and why was the video still up. It was to the point where I commented on that video, why is it still up? And shortly thereafter, it actually got taken down and Blaire showed up with an apology. Now, there are good parts to this apology and there are bad parts to it. I mean, the good things is she outright corrects the misinformation. She takes full responsibility for the hate that Janae received. She claims that she reached out and personally apologized to Janae. And she offered to send Janae the AdSense money that she made from spreading misinformation about her. All of this was very well and good, and I'm glad that she did that. But let's be honest, that was all just the bare minimum. Because besides that, there were a lot of awful things in this apology. She's still trying to use Janae to paint her narrative from her deleted video, starting this apology off with, unlike many other trans athletes, Janae doesn't compete in the women's division. She also makes excuses in this apology for why she couldn't do basic research. Apparently, she's just been putting out so much content for such a long time that it makes her do a bad job at the thing that she has been doing a lot and for a long time. So that makes sense. She also announces that she's going to go on a break after this, which, was she not on a break before she uploaded this? In fact, that reminds me, she didn't address the fact that she left this video up for about 3 weeks as Janae continued to get hate comment after hate comment from misinformed Blaire White fans for no reason. And Blaire was well aware of this because her entire comment section said so. What I found most insulting about this entire thing though, is Blaire didn't even post this apology to the platform where it happened. She put it on her Instagram story, which disappears after 24 hours, and she posted it on her Twitter. This tweet has 14,000 likes currently, but Blaire's original video had 400,000 views. I think it's safe to assume that while some of Blaire's viewers may have seen that statement, many of them did not. I actually found an example of someone in the wild who didn't even know she apologized. To me, it seemed like she was still trying not to let her audience know what she had done. But out of all of this, one part of her apology caught my eye. It was this statement right here.
While many people are running with the narrative that it was an intentional deception on my part, that's just not true.
So that leaves me wondering, is it not true?
So there we have it. That's part one. That's Blaire White. That's what she did. That's why she's losing subscribers.
Now, all of this kind of just sounds like an accident gone wrong. Blaire got her information incorrect. It spirals out of control. She goes into hiding and handles it poorly, but then tries to kind of maybe sort of fix it at the last minute. But in part two, we're going to look at how a pattern of behavior and themes that stretches back throughout all of Blaire's content from the very beginning points to the fact that this may have been a lot more malicious than Blaire's making it seem. How many chances do you get to mess something up before people start assuming that you're doing it on purpose? Now, if I was going to make the very bold claim that Blaire White purposely did this to make Janae look bad, then I would have to provide a track record of examples where Blaire has misrepresented facts and purposely lied to her audience in order to paint a false narrative. And unfortunately, I can do that pretty easily. The first thing that comes to mind is the JK Rowling incident. Now, a lot of YouTubers have talked about this, but the gist of it is, JK Rowling is a best-selling author who used to be best known for writing the beloved Harry Potter series, but now seems really desperate to become best known for being the least favorite person of a lot of members of the trans community. A lot of transgender people believe that JK Rowling is transphobic. I've seen some transgender people say that they believe she's not. Either way, you would need to look at her statements, the things she said, and their opinions on it to form your own conclusion. And there's a lot to form a conclusion about. See, JK Rowling has put out several offhand tweets, an entire Twitter thread, and even this weird manifesto-esque statement about the trans community and her opinions on trans people. She's become a hot topic politically, with some people holding her up as an example of free speech that must be protected against the angry PC mob who tries to cancel anybody who says things they don't like. Hashtag I stand with JK Rowling became like a trend, so I feel like she would be fine whether y'all stood with her or not, but what would I know? All this to say, there's a political incentive to downplay JK Rowling's transphobia, and this is something that Blaire White has done on numerous occasions.
I personally do not find JK Rowling to be transphobic. Period. Before I even read these tweets, I, as a trans woman, did not find these offensive or transphobic at all.
Now, these were both Blaire reacting to statements that JK Rowling made that could go either way, if you don't look at them closely enough. But when Rowling released a book that includes a serial killer character that was actually a man in a dress that tricks women, that way he can take them out, you know, in context with all her other weird statements and the entire manifesto, it definitely came across as transphobic to a lot of people. I can't say whether it was transphobic or not because I didn't read the book, but thankfully for us, Blaire White did. She did so quickly, in fact, that she managed to get a video review up of it in less than a week after the book came out.
Just a heads up, I read the book. I spent the last 12 hours reading it as an ebook, and so the opinions you're going to hear today are from someone who is not just, you know, on Twitter hearing what other people have to say and hopping on a bandwagon. This is because I read the book.
The thing is, the book is 900 pages long, so it's not impossible to read a 900-page book in one day. I just don't find that very feasible. But taking her at face value, Blaire claims that not only did she read it, but that the controversy was completely overblown, because apparently this serial killer's cross-dressing tendencies were only mentioned in one part of the book. And that's when I realized my problem with Blaire White's video.
It comes in the form of one line in the book, one page in a 900-page book, and it's where the killer is described in one of the instances of him snatching a woman up as wearing a disguise of a wig and a woman's coat. That's it. I'm not kidding. That's it.
She never actually shows us the line in question. She literally just says, it's only one line, guys. Trust me. And she could have easily screenshotted it since she said she was reading an ebook version. And she probably didn't do so because she knows that it's more than one line. Now, I wanted to fact check Blaire on this, but I did not want to read through a 900-page book just so I could make one point in a YouTube video. So thankfully, I was able to find someone who had read the first 10 chapters of the book. And I know this because they actually showed screenshots of the book on screen. So this is coming from the YouTuber Samantha Lux.
However, also in chapter 8, literally a few pages later, it says again he's suspected of wearing women's clothing to get access to one of his female victims.
In her video review, Blaire had also claimed that cross-dressing wasn't even really part of the character's identity. It was just something he did to get the women.
It's just the disguise he's used to get women. It's not like that was his lifestyle or who he was, the character.
Rowling writes that due to a traumatic past, Creed found refuge in fantasy, and sometimes he would incorporate materials from the real world into those fantasies.
Yeah, it turns out that wasn't true either. Now, I recommend watching the rest of Samantha's video because she actually shows the things she's talking about on screen so you can come to your own conclusions, versus Blaire White, who never really gives you enough information for you to be able to form anything other than the conclusion that she's already given you, which seems strangely motivated to make J.K. Rowling look better than she is. She's either lying about what was in the book, or she's lying about the fact that she read the book at all, which, considering the fact that it was 900 pages, I feel like it's 50-50. Now, that one example is not enough for me to think she would do something like falsely accused Janae, knowing that it could have been fact-checked. But this next example pretty much is. Now, people bring this picture of Blaire White up a lot to prove that she's secretly racist, but here's the thing. I understand that this is a black face mask. Well, not a black face mask, it's like a black it's a skin treatment. It's not inherently racist at all. Blaire herself addresses this in a video called "The Truth About My Racist Past."
It's a beauty treatment. It's a mud mask. It's a face mask. How actually mentally deficient do you have to be to think that I would unabashedly even post a blackface picture?
The problem, though, is that that's not the problem anyone has with this. The problem was the caption.
Blaire Black, intersectional trans feminist, depressed, mentally ill, hashtag Black Lives Matter, non-binary dragon king.
So, yeah. As far as I'm concerned, this is in fact blackface. Like, your alibi that you were just applying a face mask doesn't mean much when you painted your face dark, dark black and then went online and started imitating a poorly done stereotype of a black person, which is straight up blackface. I mean, calling yourself Blaire Black and putting hashtag Black Lives Matter when your skin is literally the color black. And I know you're gonna say, but D'Angelo, her second channel is called Blaire Black. And it's like, I know, I'm the one who told you that. Try to keep up. We all know why she put Blaire Black. So instead of addressing, oh yeah, this was just like an edgy joke I was trying to make, Blaire crops the caption out of the post and claims in her video that people were just mad at her for wearing a face mask.
I'm not going to apologize because you think that this is racist. I'm not going to apologize because you think that a face mask is blackface.
Now, I'm bringing this up to prove that Blaire has no problem willingly manipulating information to paint a story that's not true. I'm not bringing it up because I believe that one racist joke means that you are a diehard racist. I do, however, think casually saying the N-word means you're probably racist.
Leonard caught me slipping, I guess, and I said the word nigga while I was fairly intoxicated. It's not really part of my vocabulary normally, not because I'm, you know, afraid of offending people.
I know that casually saying the N-word with a hard R means you're definitely racist.
It's literally is the N-word with a hard R because they're angry at someone and they scream it at them.
I don't care. And I'll be super honest. I like do that when I'm playing video games, or I do that if I like stub my toe. Like it, I do that. So I don't really care.
You scream things out of anger. You scream the N-word hard R.
Sometimes.
Oh my God. Okay.
I didn't see her address those in the Truth About My Racist Past video. And I'm going to be honest. If you manage to stop Onision, of all people, in his tracks, then you need to rethink your entire life. Now, both of these examples to me are pretty cut and dry. Covering for J.K. Rowling is one thing. Lying about her blackface controversy is another. But covering for Jeffree Star was actually incredibly disturbing. Now, I actually mentioned this situation myself months ago, which I'm happy about because now y'all can't go in the comments saying you only dislike Blaire White now because people are mad at her. I've legitimately held the opinions I'm sharing in this video for a while now. A lot of people in the comment section pointed out that Blaire played right into Jeffree's hands, and honestly, whether or not this was intentional, I can't really say. I mean, Blaire has been on record before misrepresenting facts to cover for Jeffree in the Davi Vanity situation. But anyway, notice how at the time I said I didn't know whether Blaire White had done that on purpose or not. Yeah, well, no, now I'm pretty confident that she did that on purpose to make Jeffree look good. Here's what happened. Washed up MySpace singer Davi Vanity is a convicted child molester. That much is a fact. And Jeffree Star previously admitted to seeing him
do this criminal act. Then Jeffrey retracted this witness statement a year later, went on tour with Davi, and claims that they were brothers and everything was good now. And to this day, he claims that he never saw anything happen. Now, this was a disgusting move on multiple levels. Not only was he protecting a predator for a financial gain, but he also made it much more difficult for the victims to come forward, what with Jeffree Star being such a high profile person, now backing Davi instead of them. Commentary channel Tamimi made a video when she explains this entire situation in much more detail than I have time to. But Blaire White wanted to make a video about it too. So she took Tamimi's clip and, you probably see where this is going,
clipped it out and made it seem like, wow, Jeffree Star is this hero for saying something about Davi Vanity and never mentioned the fact that he had retracted his statement.
So why did Blaire manipulate the context of Tamimi's clip to paint a completely different narrative that didn't happen in order to cover for somebody who is protecting a predator? Well, I'm pretty sure it's just literally because Blaire White is a Jeffree Star stan.
I used to be, I still am a huge Jeffree Star fan, and back then I loved the music.
Now, Blaire White did wind up apologizing for this and claiming that she got her facts wrong, but she never actually addressed the fact that the video she had to watch to include Tamimi's clip started off with Tamimi saying that Jeffree had retracted his statement. It's also worth noting that this apology Blaire gave was on a live stream. You ready for this? Not on her channel. Now, here's the crazy part. Even though I've given these three examples, there's a lot more where they came from. I just specifically went with these three because, in my opinion, it's very cut and dry that these couldn't have been mistakes. A lot of the misinformation that Blaire White puts out, it could be argued that she didn't know what she was doing. But in these cases, there's no way that she didn't. And here's the thing that I realized. Blaire White's information isn't accurate, because she's not even actually trying to be accurate. To confirm this, you would have to take a look at her content outside of YouTube. Remember that I mentioned she's a writer for the Postmillennial? Yeah, her work with the Postmillennial is a little bit concerning. First of all, how are you gonna write articles when you can't even do basic research? But that's besides the point. Many of Blaire's Postmillennial articles correspond to her video topics. And we've just looked at a few of Blaire White's videos, so let's take a look at the articles. AK Rowling canceled for her transphobic book that contains no trans characters or storyline. The subtitle says, "The book has virtually nothing to do with trans people, and anyone claiming otherwise is lying, has not read the book, or both." You know what? This is weird. This is giving me propaganda vibes. Do not trust anyone who holds an opinion other than mine, because they simply don't know what they're talking about, or they're lying, or both. And that's an especially weird position, seeing as it's coming from the person who's lying. It boils down to one line in a book of 900 pages that has sparked this outrage. And of course, I personally have read on screen in Samantha's videos with my own eyes multiple lines that go into detail about this character, his cross-dressing tendencies, and how that plays into his identity. But okay, you can hear my full review and thoughts of Troubled Blood by JK Rowling in my new YouTube video. Wait, so she links her YouTube videos in her own articles? I mean, normally that wouldn't be a problem, but her own YouTube videos are not credible, so by extension, these articles are just not credible. It's like this weird loop. She seems credible because she's a writer for the Postmillennial, but she's a writer for the Postmillennial because she seems credible. At no point in this loop is actual credibility involved, and I'm starting to think that's because she simply has not. Oh, here's another one.
Disgraced singer Davi Vanity back after allegations.
Now, this article starts off well enough. It serves as a warning that Davi Vanity has slithered back onto social media, and that people don't realize, yeah, he's still allegedly a child molester. But in this article, look who pops up.
YouTube sensation Jeffree Star once took to Twitter after completing a tour with Davi Vanity, outing him for the crime.
And no mention of Jeffree Star's retraction even once. And bam, a link to her video in which she manipulated Tamimi's clip to prove a point that never happened. But here's the biggest issue I have with all of this. Even though Blaire released her apology on Twitter to Janae, there's still an article up on the Postmillennial about Blaire's video on trans athletes. And guess who the cover is? Janae Marie Kroc, a woman who has never competed against other women in her entire life. This is actually pathetic. Now, I will say, Janae is not mentioned in this article, which, first of all, it's weird to use the cover of her when that's the case anyway. But if you have never heard of her and you see her with this title, then the next time you see her, how could you think anything other than the fact that she competes against other women? And unlike Blaire's comment section, the Postmillennial has no comments for people to talk about
how there's misinformation in this article. There's no view count, i.e. there's no way to know how many people have read this and taken it at face value. These articles probably show up in random people's feeds, making the extent of the misinformation that Blaire has spread literally untrackable. And lo and behold, even though she didn't lie about Janae in the article, she had still linked to her video while it was up. To be clear, there's nothing wrong with getting something wrong in a story. I've done that multiple times. It's possible that I could be doing it in this video, but I do try to check everything really hard. But the issue is, absolutely everything is wrong with knowing that something is wrong and putting it in your video anyway, because it makes you sound right about something else that you believe. And then making the excuse that you just made a mistake every single time you get called out on it, if you even choose to address it at all. This is Blaire's actual line of work. And I got that line from Halsey of all people. Halsey's a Grammy-nominated, chart-topping American pop star. Earlier this month, she tweeted out, "Why are nightclubs in LA open? What is going on?" She's of course questioning the decision to open these spaces encouraging public gatherings in the middle of a pandemic. Blaire White, in all of her Twitter finger glory, tries to epically own Halsey by posting a picture of her at a gathering without a mask. And the caption, "Shut up." Except, as Halsey pointed out, drawing this comparison was extremely stupid because she only had her mask off for 1 second. Plus, she was at a civil rights protest, not a nightclub, and she was surrounded by people wearing masks. Blaire White couldn't even think of a response, so she just deleted her entire reply, and now all that remains is Halsey just ending her on Twitter. And someone pointed out how pathetically Blaire tried and failed to make Halsey look bad. Halsey responded with,
"Based on her line of work, that type of selective information pulling is the norm for her."
And that's actually what made it click in my head. This is Blaire's line of work. This is her job. When she gets information, she doesn't think, "Let me spread this to my audience." She thinks, "How can I use this to support something that I want my audience to believe?" And then she changes it to whatever it needs to be, and then spreads that to her audience. So all of this really does raise the question of why Blaire is doing this. What does she gain, besides the obvious being like 1 million subscribers and hella views on her channel? Of course, I can't know what's inside her head, but I do have some suspicions. Now, I mentioned earlier that I used to be a pretty big fan of Blaire White, but when I stopped watching her, I didn't just unsubscribe. I stopped and questioned myself and had to evaluate why I was ever subscribed in the first place. I could claim that it was just because I wanted to hear the opinions of a trans person, but if anything has become clear by now, there are much better people on the platform who can speak up for their trans experiences. Janae Marie Kroc comes to mind, by the way. I watched her entire documentary, Transformer, and this documentary wasn't about becoming transgender. It was legitimately just about Janae accepting herself. Janae held herself up as a positive example and basically said through her actions, "I am just like you." And I think that's a much more important message than weird trans person of the week number 84. Janae's reasoning for doing this is so different from Blaire's.
"I look forward to a point where people can just be themselves, you know, no matter what it is, and no one will think anything of that."
What I'm saying here is Janae's whole presence kind of challenges me to be a better person when it comes to trans people. And Blaire's entire presence kind of just exists to make other trans people look bad. And I think she's doing it on purpose. See, Blaire has always had a vendetta against people like Janae since the beginning of her channel. Now, I'm not bringing these 2016 videos up to say, "Look, Blaire White used to be like this, so this is proof that she's still like this in 2020, because no. I'm bringing them up because they establish a pattern of behavior that I still recognize in her current content. She's still like this. See, in 2016, she uploaded a video called "Trans I'm not gonna read that one out loud. And don't be fooled by the video quality. This really is from 2016, not 2006. Don't be fooled by the video quality or lack thereof. But basically, in 2016, Blaire seemed to have a problem with literally all trans people that weren't exactly like her. Like, if you were anywhere between or outside of trans man or trans woman, then Blaire doesn't support you.
So I think this meme pretty much sums up how I feel, but I will go into more detail. So yeah, I think all these identities are largely bullshit.
Now, I'm not non-binary, so I'm not like offended on behalf of anybody, but I am offended at this meme. How is this 2016? This meme looks like it was from 2012 at best. Anyway, Blaire's current objective of being a liaison for trans people is certainly questionable, seeing as it doesn't seem to extend to people who are different than her. I mean, disagreeing with someone's existence is a choice, and she's entitled to that. But back in 2016, I still found an example of her misrepresenting somebody just because she didn't agree with them.
My pronouns are not preferred. They're not a preference. I don't expect everyone in the world to understand my identity. I barely understand my identity myself. You don't have to understand someone to respect them or their wishes.
I mean, I agree with that. You don't have to necessarily understand someone to respect them, but hopefully your idea of respect is reasonable. I mean, you're not going to hit me with some crazy pronoun like Zim or Zer, right?
This person literally said, I am not demanding that you understand me. I am just expecting respect by asking you to call me by my proper pronouns. And Blaire has to flip it into, oh yeah, well, what if your pronouns are crazy? But then Blaire cut out the part where this person gave their pronouns. So I went and found like this old video with barely any views. This person's pronouns are they and them, you know, two existing English words that we already use to refer to people when we don't know their gender. Now, like I said, both of these examples are from 2016. And what I was looking for was a common theme. So as I continue to watch your content, I found this clip from 2018.
One of these things is not like the other.
Which one stands out, bitch?
You can call yourself whatever you want. The biggest thing to me is that like this person is paraded around. This person will get casted. This person will be able to go and do huge conferences and speak about trans people and as if they really know. And for me,
as if they've been through anything that we've actually been
anything.
Through.
Anything.
This person's literally using our identities as a way to make money and a way to basically endorse himself.
That's you know? True, actually. Like he makes money from
they're
it.
They're taking advantage. He's taking advantage of us, basically, if you think about it. You know what I mean?
In a way.
This comes across as extremely bitter to me, and it's not why I stopped watching her, but I'm definitely glad I stopped watching her. Now we have one from 2019.
In terms of gender, I have about as much in common with a non-binary person as I do my fiance, who is not trans, just a guy, because he stayed at point A. Just like non-binary people do.
See, this doesn't even make sense to me because people who are non-binary, they don't start at point A and then stop at point A. They might not have gone from point A to point B for Blaire the same way that she did, but they're non-binary. That is a different gender expression than the one that they were assigned when they were born. By definition, Merriam-Webster, the Oxford English Dictionary, and Johns Hopkins University of Medicine, like that means they're transgender. So as I was watching her, I really started to question, why does my acceptance of Blaire White have to rely so heavily on not accepting these other people who haven't done anything other than not be exactly like her? Now, Blaire claims to have legitimate reasons for trying so desperately to distance herself from the other trans people, and she's perfectly valid in her right to want to do so. But what's absolutely not okay is how she attributes things that they didn't do to their entire community in order to make them look bad, claiming things like, they're trying to destroy the gender binary.
No, I am not trying to bash non-binary people. I'm not trying to say that I'm better than them, above them, higher than them. We all put our pants on one leg at a time. We are all equals here. What I am saying is that we are different, okay? It seems to me that the goal of non-binary people is to completely destroy and deconstruct the binary. And the goal of trans people is to operate within the binary, as in moving from one to the other. Transitioning.
Like, first of all, nobody can destroy the gender binary even if they're claiming that they want to. That's just an extremely reactionary thing to say. And secondly, why is she saying that non-binary people want to do this when she's only given examples of like a few people who happen to be non-binary who said they want to do that? Isn't that why she claims to make content in the first place, so that people will not project the actions of a few onto her entire community?
Remember when the conversation used to be being born a boy, transitioning to a woman, moving on, like, and vice versa. That is no longer the conversation. The conversation is completely dominated by identifying as both and neither, identifying as, it's different now.
Like many things, Blaire says, this is another observably untrue thing that is designed solely to elicit a negative reaction towards people that Blaire already doesn't like. If you look at the conversation about trans people, surely by the numbers, it's dominated by people like Blaire White. She's the one with a million subscribers, or she was the one with a million subscribers before she lost them. The conversation is absolutely not dominated by non-binary, non-gender conforming people like the ones that I only ever seem to hear about when Blaire White brings them up in the first. Wait a minute, did you realize that nearly every single person Blaire White brings up fits this description? They literally all have, to some extent, various elements that most people would associate with either male or female.
And the same thing goes for Jamie at the end of the panel, the other non-binary individual who was born male, has no intention and has never transitioned ever. So again, stayed at point A, but yet I'm supposed to believe that I'm the same as these two guys, really.
In other words, unlike Blaire, we can't just put them in a box for us to feel comfortable. In other words, they all look weirder than Blaire. And by the way, I'm not saying they look weird. Blaire is the one heavily implying that these people are weirder than her.
I will say, a lot of the people who I typically disagree with tend to have a wacky appearance. But is that my fault?
No.
No. It's not your fault. It's just really not our fault that the people who we disagree with tend to like go out of their way to look crazy.
Yeah, you guys just choose to look that way. Like, it's not our fault.
Y'all, Blaire White is straight up just attacking people who look different than her. See, it's not just the quotes here or the one thing here. It's this entire pattern. And now when I think about the fact that she has gone after somebody like Janae Marie Kroc, who absolutely fits the description of being non-binary and says so, I'm nearly positive that Blaire White has done this on purpose, because it's what she's always done since 2016, is try to make these people look bad so Blaire can feel better. In fact, Blaire still made a point to comment on Janae's appearance in her video.
That is some amazing bodybuilding. Like, that's crazy. Like, who looks like that? Like, no one looks like that. And I am not trying to make fun of her appearance. I know people will just run to that because people like to just say I'm a big old meanie rather than addressing any of my points, but I'm really not making fun of her appearance. I mean, I think that obviously her appearance is outlandish, and I think that even she would admit that, because how could she not? But that's not the point. The bigger point is...
You know, looking back, I don't know how I didn't come to this conclusion earlier, but Blaire White is consciously taking her disdain for trans people like Janae, projecting it onto the entire community of trans people who don't look like her, and then relying on the biases of her giant cisgender audience made up of people like me to agree with her that people like Janae are bad for existing. Now, this isn't my original observation in any way. In fact, many, many trans YouTubers have put out statements and videos explaining this very phenomenon. I don't feel the need to add to or repeat their talking points in my video, but I do feel the need to talk about my own talking points. See, I haven't yet seen a cis YouTuber who used to watch Blaire White admit the effect that she's having on cis people watching her videos. Harming the trans community is one thing, and people have spoken up about that, but I really would like to talk a bit about how Blaire White is relying on the biases of cisgender people to do so. So here's my experience. I didn't know that Blaire White was transgender when I first encountered her. It's not just me either. If you go through her comment section, you're bound to find at least one comment on any video saying, "Whoa, I had no idea you were transgender." Because I never thought that she was transgender when I first encountered her, I never put any of my false preconceived notions onto Blaire. And Blaire knows this, and then proceeds to take people who cis people like me can visually identify as possibly being transgender and relies on our preconceived notions of them and enables them. That way we can mutually feel justified about tearing these people down. Blaire White wants trans people to look as crazy as possible. That way she, by extension, can look better. If they don't look outlandish or wacky enough, and of course these are her words, not mine, then she will go out of her way to make them seem that way. What other reason could she possibly have for photoshopping a beard onto this person for her thumbnail, other than to make people who are not transgender go like, "Oh, what's that?" In fact, Blaire did the same thing with her thumbnail for Janae. She didn't photoshop her, to my knowledge, but she highlighted the fact that Janae used to look like this, but now she looks like this. And meanwhile, Blaire still looks like this. You know, if I used a picture of Blaire before she transitioned and compared it to one of how she looks now in the thumbnail for this video, what point do you think I would be trying to drive home? If I took a picture of Blaire White and I photoshopped a beard onto her for this thumbnail, how is that going to come across, and what would my intentions be? And how would they be any different than what Blaire's intentions are? I don't believe that they are. On the other hand, she doesn't just do this visually. If the trans person in question has ideas or statements that aren't out there enough to make cis people feel uncomfortable so they can want to see them get torn down, then Blaire makes up her own statements. I mean, the title of the video on Janae was, "I belong in women's sports, get over it for crying out loud." And as we know, Janae has never at any point said that. She has another video right here called "I'm transgender for attention," which is also in quotation marks. And the person in this video also never said that. I went back and found the original video she's reacting to, because at this point, I have to fact check everything Blaire's doing. And in this video, this person is talking about how her experience doesn't take away from other people's experiences. And Blaire flips it and makes it sound like she's saying the opposite. Blaire wants people like me to believe wholeheartedly that trans people are irrational, unless they're exactly like Blaire, who happens to be one of the good ones. And she has her justifications for why she does this, claiming that it makes her life easier but not being associated with these people, etc. But when I ask myself, what reason do I have for critiquing this content, I came up very short. The cis people watching Blaire's content, of which there are many, are not transgender. We do not deal with transgender issues in our lives. We do not even exist in transgender spaces. So what does it matter how other people are living their lives, and why do we need Blaire to come every week and tell us about the latest one that she thinks is weird? If you think about when she rose to prominence, it was legitimately with her Trans Predator series. And of course, I am in no way implying that you should not call out predators. But why was it called Trans Predators? If I made a video about Jessica Yaniv and I called it Trans Predator, I wouldn't get praised for that. I would get rightfully questioned as to why I am associating two things that have nothing to do with each other. Unfortunately, I can vouch for the fact that a lot of people are coming to Blaire White's channel just to see the worst of the trans community delivered by the most tolerable trans person we've seen. And what I'm trying to say here basically is, like, I was super transphobic when I was watching her content. I'm not saying, like, oh, I was raised this way or I didn't know. I legitimately believed that trans people were irrational unless they were exactly like Blaire White. And that's insane. The thing is, I wasn't what I thought transphobic meant. Like, I wouldn't walk up in the street to somebody who I thought was transgender and say, you're still a man, or you're not a real woman, or you'll never be non-binary. And I'm not going to use the wrong pronouns to misgender somebody just so, I don't know, I can feel better about myself. I would not do those things, so I thought I was good. But I absolutely had an aversion to trans people who did not fit in boxes that made me comfortable to begin with. And so I flocked to Blaire White's channel because she markets her content to people who are exactly like me in that situation. Well, I've come to realize, as I've tried really hard to systematically reject all of my biases, is that these people are not different than me. And I'm not talking about, like, non-binary trans people or any subgroup of people. Nobody is different from me. That's the concept that I wasn't getting before. Like, if you are a woman, or if you're Asian, or you're Muslim, or whatever, you are the exact same as I am. And so when I think about how I held beliefs, and I may have previously treated people in a way that doesn't make them feel like they are the same as me, I tend to regret that very deeply. I regret it because it makes me think of times when I have been let known that I am not the same as everyone else. And I'm sorry that I used to think it was okay to make anyone feel that way. I am. I didn't need, like, a Twitter mob to come after me. I didn't need people forcing me to apologize. I just had to step back and realize, why am I doing this? I don't want to be a person who will see somebody and say, oh, you're not a real trans person because you don't have this, this, and this medical condition. No, I want to be somebody who everyone can look at and say, oh, wow, he's just like me. Because that's the same basic respect that I look for in my life, and I don't always find it. Despite all of our differences, I do believe that we are inherently the same. And that's the basis of acceptance, not that there is some people in groups that are close enough to me to make me feel comfortable. Now, I'm obviously not saying that everybody in Blaire White's entire fan base is exactly like me. But I will definitely say I've seen enough comments on her page that are identical to things I was thinking when I was like that. That is very concerning, the audience that she's managed to build on YouTube. And she's going to have to deal with that. I won't be a part of it. In my opinion, Blaire White is the most irrational one out of them all. And it's not because she's transgender or for any reason other than the fact that she is a liar who wants to manipulate the emotions of the whole world into becoming evidence for something that she knows isn't true. And that's what I wanted to explore in part two. And this is coincidentally where the video would have ended, but of course Blaire White had to come back. So, in part three, Blaire White makes her triumphant return, except it seems like she tried to do that while alerting as few people as possible. I mean, 12 days after her pathetic Twitter apology, she uploads a video called Let's Talk, and literally everything was wrong with it, down to the name. Putting Let's Talk instead of I'm sorry is a really sad move, because it makes it look more like a channel update than an apology video. And if you've uploaded enough videos, you know that everybody clicks into an apology video, and, like, nobody clicks into a channel update. That's probably why this video has just over 200,000 views, which is like half of the views that she wound up getting on the video with the misinformation. She also didn't promote this video on her Twitter or Instagram, even though she's posted every previous video on those platforms before, from what I could see. I've never seen somebody come back and hide at the same time. Anyway, there are good things and bad things in her apology video, much like her Twitter statement. For one, she sort of reiterates the points that she put in writing. Like, she explicitly shows the clip where she was wrong and corrects it.
I was under the misconception that she competes in both men and women's leagues. She corrected it and said, actually, just men's leagues. And to be frank, there is just no excuse for that kind of inaccuracy to be present in any of my videos, and I definitely never want it to happen again.
She also admits, finally, that with a platform her size, she can't afford to just make mistakes like this.
The reality is, a lot of people are watching, and, you know, I can't take it back, but I definitely, as I have been stating, am incredibly apologetic, and I never want that to happen ever, ever again.
She took responsibility for the wave of hate that Janae got after Blaire misrepresented her like that.
Even if Janae competed in women's leagues, it was never my intention to send hate her way. I didn't want any hate sent her way, but I also understand that if that's the effect, then that's the effect, and it's still my doing, and I take full responsibility for that.
And she even acknowledges that apologies are useless without changed behavior, and she promises not to do this again.
Unfortunately, I cannot promise that I'm never going to get anything else wrong, because I am human, and I definitely am going to get things wrong. But what I can promise is to work my absolute hardest to not let this type of thing happen again, to minimize the cracks for which an inaccuracy can slip through, and to just be more steadfast in reactions to things as well.
So it's like, is this an acceptable apology? Kind of. I call it the Jeffree Star approach. Like, basically just apologize for the things that weren't really that bad. Then you said sorry, and you never had to actually address what you did wrong. Like, getting something wrong in a video isn't a bad action. That just means you messed up. So with that being said, why didn't she address any of her actual actions?
I'm seeing a sentiment of people who definitely want me to talk about this again, but this time in video form, and I actually want to as well, so I'm here to do that.
Nobody was asking her to talk about this in video form. We can read. We wanted her to talk about it on the same platform that she spread the misinformation on, which was much larger than her Twitter.
While I know some people think this was intentional deception on my part, I can guarantee you this is not the case. Lying about something that the public can then go correct you on is only slightly more dumb than not doing enough research and coming to a false conclusion.
The issue with this assertion is that she's done exactly what she's saying. As dumb as she maintains that it is, I've shown examples in my video of her lying about things that can easily be fact-checked.
I don't know how I went from the video prior to that one with overnight shipping a long, obnoxiously thick novel of J.K. Rowling's for research to doing such incredibly subpar research on the second video, but I did, and it was dumb, and I am sorry.
Wait a minute, she's talking about the J.K. Rowling book? How did she say she got it?
Overnight shipping a long, obnoxiously thick novel.
Overnight shipping? But I thought she said in her book review that
I spent the last 12 hours reading it as an ebook.
So she didn't read it. The fact that she brings this up as an example of her credibility, like the only example you have that you don't lie is of your last video, which was a lie.
Also, I know that some people are critical of the delayed response I had when I apologized to Janae, and for that, I also have to say I'm sorry. I think the unfortunate thing is it took me a lot longer than it should have to differentiate between valid criticism and hate.
This is just a blatant lie, because as I mentioned earlier, I commented on her video asking why it was still up. And while I was there, I obviously read a bunch of the comments. They weren't saying, oh, Blaire White, we hate you. We hope you stubbed your toe every day. That would be kind of brutal, actually. No, they were more so like Janae's. They were very calmly saying, hey, this is misinformation. Maybe you should stop spreading it. To write it off as, I thought it was hate, is extremely disingenuous. There's no way you could read those and think, oh, wow, people mad for no reason. So, apology video aside, it was just futile because she still hasn't addressed the main issue. I mean, Blaire claims that it was an honest mistake, but the real question is, where did she get this information from if she didn't just make it up in order to make Janae look bad? In her original video, she didn't cite a single tweet or article or source that said that Janae was competing in women's events. And do you know why? Because they don't exist. If you Google Janae Marie Kroc, There are no examples of things saying that she's competed against women. So where did Blaire get this information from? In fact, if you Google Janae, it says in several places things like,
previously competed as a professional powerlifter. She was one of the most successful and popular athletes in the sport of powerlifting prior to her transition. Janae Marie Kroc is back competing as a male.
And this is literally from last year, by the way. These are all at the top of the page without scrolling or even clicking into the results. So yeah, no, Blaire White did this on purpose and then went on her channel and apologized for doing it accidentally. And somehow the apology still worked on everyone. Even though Blaire made sure as little of her audience as possible watched her apology, the top comments are still pretty divided between people supporting her and people calling her out. The positive comments seem to conclude that it is in fact a good video.
Just straight up said what she did and why it was a mistake. Good job, Blaire.
Yeah, this would be a good apology if the thing that she apologized for was the thing that she did.
You took it down, you corrected the record, and you apologized. I think the case is closed. You have 1,000 times the integrity of most journalists.
I would more so say she has the exact amount of integrity that I've come to expect from most journalists. Also, yes, she did do all of those things after weeks of people contacting her and practically pleading her to. It's not exactly like the hallmark of responsibility.
At least she's big enough to admit when she made a mistake and corrected it. I wholly support this.
Okay, at this point, y'all are just hyping her up for doing the bare minimum, which is not only weird, but somewhat ironic considering she didn't even do the bare minimum. I almost feel bad for the people commenting though, because I remember feeling the same way. For once, I don't blame the people for accepting this apology. Because Blaire White is just extremely misleading. If the only context you have are her videos as they come out, it legitimately could seem like she's doing a good thing from day to day. And this apology seems sufficient if you don't have the full story, which Blaire White never provides to her audience. Now, like I said, the comments were split. I mean, those were the nice ones, but there were a lot calling out the lack of substance.
The problem with that is that apologies don't mean anything if you keep making the same mistakes over and over again.
I would go so far as to say apologies don't mean anything coming from Blaire in general, because she doesn't even apologize for the mistakes she made in the first place. At this point, she would have to explicitly apologize for purposely misleading people for me to believe it at all.
You literally used conveniently cropped pictures to draft a narrative that simply wasn't true.
It's true that Blaire included a picture of the caption in which Janae explicitly states she's competing against women, but it wasn't cropped, it just wasn't scrolled down. Now, I of course do believe Blaire read it and purposely chose not to scroll down and include the rest of Janae's statement because she knew that it would shoot her arguments down. So I definitely agree with the sentiment of this statement.
I just don't understand why it took you until you started losing subscribers to take down the video and actually address the issue.
I understand why. Currently, Blaire White has lost 21,000 subscribers from this whole ordeal. She now has a ways to go if she's trying to hit 1 million again. And this apology video is the bare minimum she has to do if she wants to stop hemorrhaging subscribers at this point. Now, I actually left a comment of my own on Blaire's video.
The only way I would believe that you didn't read the caption of the screenshot that you captured and inserted into your video with the context cut off at the bottom is if I believed you were stupid, Blaire. I really wish I was blessed with a fraction of the patience Janae must have.
And guess what? My comment was removed from the video. Now, even though my comment is most certainly missing, I'm not sitting here and saying Blaire White took my comment down, because it's possible that that might not have happened, and unlike Blaire White, I tend not to accuse people of things that I can't prove on my channel. Now, I can still see the comment when I'm on my own account, but if I open the link in a new tab signed out, it's not there, meaning this comment is not public on her video, and there's only three ways this could have happened. It was either caught in the spam filter, deleted by Blaire herself, or automatically blocked. So let's go through our options. It definitely was not caught in the spam filter. I mean, this isn't an uncommon occurrence. At one point, I had over 6,000 comments stuck in mine. But the thing is, your comments only get flagged like this if you've been commenting similar things on a bunch of people's videos, or if they contain potentially controversial words or phrases. And I think it's safe to assume I wasn't commenting, "Hey, I don't believe you put this in here. Also, I wish I had the same patience as Janae did," unlike a bunch of people's videos. And the only word that I could think of that could possibly be construed as controversial is stupid. So I searched the comment section and easily found another one that has the word in there. So no, my comment was not stuck in the spam filter. There's only two other ways it could have gotten removed. Now, I initially did think Blaire deleted my comment, because if someone comments on your channel and they have like a higher subscriber count, YouTube will notify you. So it's possible that she saw my comment the moment it went up and just tapped deleted. But the more I've thought about that, the more I realized that would be really dumb. I mean, here I am sitting here on the channel this size telling you that my comment's gone. So why would she set herself up for that? I don't think she would. So I'm going to go ahead and rule out the fact that Blaire removed my comment because she honestly might not have seen it. And so that means only one thing, which is literally the saddest option out of all of them. My comment was automatically blocked because Blaire White blocked the word Janae from her entire comment section. Now this is a huge claim to make, so I knew I was going to have to back it up. So I used the website Hadzi to perform a comprehensive search through her entire comment section. And I was only able to find misspellings of Janae. The word Janaea with the last two letters transposed shows up 3 times. The words Janet and Janie show up once each. And the letters for Janae show up 4 times, but each of those is part of the word Janae's, as in the possessive form. And as far as YouTube's comment system is concerned, that's not the same word as Janae. In other words, there are no results for the word Janae on Blaire White's entire comment section of an apology video towards Janae Marie Kroc. While I was searching through those comments, I saw that someone had actually reposted my comment just to see if they could get it past the spam filter, and they did. It was word for word identical to mine, except they changed the spelling of Janae to Jane. So shout out Carla for doing that, by the way, that really helps me back up my case. So this left me with one further question. Did Blaire block her name out from the apology video or her entire channel? I decided to go to the video before this one, the JK Rowling one, and I left a comment with Janae's name in it on an account that there's no way she would even see a comment from because it's too small. I opened that link in a new tab where I was signed out and bam. It didn't show, meaning it never got posted in the first place. That's it. I'm confident in saying Blaire White blocked Janae's name for her entire channel. So even if she's somehow sorry, she's not ready to even have a conversation with y'all about it.
And that's probably why she went right back to uploading 5 days later and presumably will never mention Janae again.
At this point, my opinion of Blaire White has taken the biggest 180 I've ever had out of any content creator I followed online. I legitimately thought she was the pinnacle of rational truth. But at this point, I wouldn't even believe her if she told me the sky was blue unless she backed it up with some photo evidence. And for all I know, that photo evidence would be photoshopped. Why do the clouds look like a beard, Blaire? This is a little weird. Anyway, I'm feeling like this whole Blaire White situation kind of says a lot about how we live in a society, unironically. Like, what are the lessons that I'm taking away? Well, first of all, my opinion on YouTubers that brag about how everyone hates them is now like zero. Blaire definitely fits in that category. Like, her YouTube channel description is your problematic fave. And yeah, that did used to be true for me, but now she's one of my least faves, so I guess you're just problematic. Her pinned comment on her JK Rowling video says,
I think it's safe to say JK Rowling has taken my crown as public enemy number one of the trans community.
This is honestly just such a weird thing to brag about. You know, like, there are people who don't like me either. At this point, any video I upload easily gets 1,000 dislikes, sometimes 2 or 3 or 16,000 dislikes. But why make that my brand when I can just focus on making good content for the people who do like it? Like, it's not a flex that nobody likes you. It just probably means you're not that great of a person. But I've seen this kind of thing before. Blaire's relationship with her core audience depends on them thinking that she's constantly under attack while constantly doing nothing wrong. This creates this parasocial relationship where if you watch her content or support her or stand up for her against valid criticism, then you feel like you're protecting her in a way. But in reality, Blaire is not under attack. In fact, she is the one starting hate campaigns against other people for no reason. Everywhere she goes, she just looks for ways to be inflammatory, like with the Housie situation. And Blaire can't even take the consequences of her own actions, what with her deleting the Housie tweet, or disappearing after misrepresenting Janae like that, or even now blocking Janae's name for her entire channel. Another thing that has really gotten driven home for me during this whole ordeal is, wow, people really need to diversify their information sources, huh? The fact that Blaire White is the one that the majority of people are watching, when the majority of other trans people I've encountered on YouTube have made videos saying, hey, yeah, no, maybe don't make her the spokesperson. Here are some opinions and facts about why you shouldn't do that, is insane. Blaire White is objectively the worst YouTuber in that entire community because, from what I've seen, she's the only one doing this with misrepresenting facts and trying to drag everyone around her down to boost herself up. So, like I said, I realized months back that following her was not something I wanted to do. And in the meantime, I found all kinds of other amazing content creators that create content that challenges me to think about things and not, like, laugh at people for existing. There's people like Sam Collins. He makes commentary videos and They're literally all funny. Like, you would just have to watch one. Like I said, he was the one who introduced the whole topic of Blaire misrepresenting Janae like that to me in the first place. There are people like Samantha Lux. I didn't get to look into her channel too much, but of course I found her during the research for this video because of her J.K. Rowling book. And from what I see, when she shows up with facts, she's talking about like studies and research papers, not just tweets. There's YouTubers like Kat Black, who I've been watching for the longest time. She posts a variety of content, anything from like relationship think pieces to movie reviews. Her True Tea series just literally always makes me consider perspectives that I wasn't previously open to. And that's pretty much why I come to YouTube in the first place. That makes me smarter. That's why I'm so smart, because I listen to people who make me feel dumb sometimes. That was just like three people. There are seriously all kinds of people you could follow. Corviday, Cops Hate Mo, Jammy Dodger. Like, the list goes on. And do you know why it's so long? Because it's not a list of like trans YouTubers. It's a list of good people, great YouTubers who happen to be trans and occasionally can speak from their perspective as trans people on issues. Like, to that point, I don't accept spokespeople from groups anymore. Never again. Like, all the people I just listed, I do think they're good YouTubers, but they're not like spokespeople for the trans community. Much in the same way, I'm not the spokesperson for like the Black community, for example. Now, yes, I am the spokesperson for the Pretty Boy Committee, but I didn't ask for that responsibility. That's just the burden I bear looking like this 24/7. But other than that, no, I don't need a Blaire White to feel okay about transgender people. That's what I learned from this situation. The fact that I did says a lot about biases that I had, and I'm in a way glad that this happened because I can confront those. For me, this is not about canceling Blaire White. I mean, she lost 21,000 subscribers before my video came out, so if anything, she went and did that to herself. And honestly, she already knows that she only makes money by doing all that stuff that I outlined in this video. For me, this entire situation is more so just about accepting the fact that society has progressed past the need for Blaire White. Well, thank you for watching my video. That was the Blaire White video that, well, I would say you were waiting for it, but I didn't announce it. So that was the surprise Blaire White video. Can you believe that this was actually supposed to be like a short video? I know you probably think I'm kidding, but I wasn't. I was initially just gonna write about like the one thing that she did, but the more I wrote the script, the more I realized, oh yeah, no, I kind of have a lot to say about this. Anyway, I definitely will not be back next week. I know it's been super fun with me uploading back to back to back, but I've posted three videos in the last 10 days and they were all like this long. So that's kind of a lot, like kind of a whole lot. But you know what? I had fun with those videos and they got hella views. So honestly, who cares?